Welcome to video 28 on Fun with Arduino. In the previous 27 videos, most of them we have been making code, and we did that using the standard Arduino IDE code editor. And that worked quite okay, but not more than that, quite okay. While there are very versatile editors around, even free of charge, that bring so much more efficiency while editing code, that it could be worthwhile to download and install and have a look, have a small learning curve with one of those editors. The one that has a very small learning curve, so very quickly to use straight out of the box, is Notepad++. So let's have a look at that one. We can find Notepad++ by simply Googling for it, and that brings us to this page, this homepage, and there we find a menu with a download link. And if we scroll down a bit, we can choose between a 32-bit version or a 64-bit version, depending on your system. Select one of those, download and install, and all is straightforward. Now that it is installed, let's try it out. Here I have the ino file of the previous video, the servo tuning with rotary encoder, fast and slow. I can right click it and select edit with Notepad++, and then it opens the editor with the file. If I would like to zoom in or out, just press the control key and at the same time rotate your mouse button to get the size of text that you like. And we can see that it does highlighting, code highlighting, so yeah, that makes the code a little bit easier to read. We also see that we have typical Arduino statements over here, like this one or this one. One of the nice features of Notepad++, if I double click on a word, it selects that word and it also selects or color highlights the other words, the same words in the entire file. So I can quickly find, for instance, if I would like to know where I have used this variable increment, I double click it and scroll down and I can immediately find where I have used that variable. It's a very convenient function. But we are drifting away. We were going to have a look how we can we get the Arduino statements highlighted. Well, that is not by default available in Notepad++. So let's go back to the web browser and download the language file. This can easily be found by Googling for Notepad++ and Arduino, two words. That will bring us to this page, and we can click this download button and it starts to download after we have had a look at some ads. And that download file is a zip file which we need to unzip, and inside is a README file, and that gives the instructions what has to be done. Mainly there is a folder that needs to be moved to the Notepad++ folder in the plugin folder. Once you have moved that folder, then go here to the menu language, and there we have to define our own language with an import. And now we have to find the XML file that came with the download, and that is with me, it was over here. Here is this Arduino language XML file. That's the one we have to open. I already did that, so I'm not going to repeat it. And then the Arduino language will be available. It now should be over here in the language menu. It should now be in the list, so I can select Arduino as my language. That's all there is to it. Well, not entirely. There are a couple of settings that would be handy to make also. Let's go to the settings menu. And then preferences, and over there in the auto-completion section, place these two tick marks, and well, you can also choose if you would like to have double brackets automatically. That's up to you, but these are the ones that are important for the so-called auto-completion. And while we are at it, let's close this one and go to, I wanted to go to the language section over here and there make a change. I already did it, but usually when you first installed Notepad++, the tab size is at 4 and this tick mark is not set. It is handy to make the tick mark to replace tabs by spaces and to make the tab size 2. Well, I like 2, maybe you like 4 or 6 or even more. That depends, of course. So these are all the settings that I like to make. And now we can enjoy Notepad++ to the fullest. Now that we have set up the Arduino language, we can use autocomplete. What does that mean? Well, suppose that I would like to add another digital read. As soon as I have typed 2 characters, it gives me a drop-down list and I can simply select and hit enter. Also, the variables and the defines that I have already prepared and that are known in the code, it has a list of that and I can select and click. So a lot less typing and a lot more selecting, which makes that we can make less type errors. And maybe even work faster. And there's a whole wealth of other functions and options available also, so it might be a good thing to have a look here at the settings preferences menu and then just walk through all these options that you have to make it work like you want it to work. And there are simple things like, I can, for instance, click here at the left of a line number that will select that whole line and I can quickly move it around, or I quickly select a whole block of code and move that around. It's all quite convenient. I can also click at the right of a line number and that makes it gives me a colored pin. Signaling me that maybe I would have to revise this line, and now I'm editing something here at the bottom, and then I can quickly go back to that line because I can quickly find it back again. Well, all kinds of nice, easy little features. Okay, suppose that we are ready now with the code editing and we would like to upload it to our Arduino. Then we have the Arduino IDE still available. I have loaded the same file over here, but there's now one thing that I need to do to couple it to Notepad. We are not going to edit here anymore, so we go to File, Preferences, and there is a setting that says use external editor. We click that and then we click OK. Now the whole field is grayed out. I cannot even edit anymore. I cannot even click here anymore. But every time when I am in Notepad and I do a save, my save icon here is red, meaning I have changes that are not yet saved. I am going to save now. And now everything is okay. And right now, when I go to the IDE environment, that new file is saved. Well, let's do an example. Over here it says 90. That should, in our case, be 180 for the maximum angle. So I'm going to have a look over here. Maximum angle 180. I do my save operation and let's have a look if the IDE has recognized that. Yes, it has. So now I can upload the code and try it out. Well, this was it for Notepad++. It's just there, it's free, and maybe it can be of use to you. It is to me. The next video, we are going to have some fun with a DCC accessory decoder. It's not too complex to build it, because the majority of the difficult work is done via a library and we have just to add some simple things that we have seen before. So we can do it and we will do it. It is more fun maybe for model railroad hobbyists than for anyone else because we are going to use DCC commands. See you back there and bye bye.